What's up everyone, welcome to the channel, and this is an upgrade video on the jetsurf DIY jetsurf. It's been a while guys, because I've had a few health issues, hospital, so I'm not uploading as frequently. Nothing serious, it's all good. So that's the reason why it's taken a while, but I've been printing. I did the 8S test the last video down the river, and I thought to myself, well, I might as well just start to upgrade the thing now, get it done, you know. So I want to make room for a 50 volt battery that I'm going to build. And after all these upgrades I'm doing, moving everything out of the way basically for the battery, and also to get the new jet drives installed, so you know, we can have a little bit more efficiency power. These things have been in for so long. So here we go, look, I've got bits and bobs, I've got all sorts of printing stuff. I've been printing like a maniac. That's all for me little battery pack and the ESCs, two ESCs go in there. So I've made a bit of a tunnel basically in the board, and we'll see that now. So let's get on with it, shall we? Hit them buttons guys, stick with me. I'm looking to grow this channel. It's not as quick as I'd like at the minute with the videoing. But once I get to full health, I can get back to kind of a more of a speedy schedule. Come with me on the ride guys, and if you're building a board, any questions, comments, love all that. So without further ado guys, let's get on with the video. Okay guys, so after all that jiggery pokery, we come into on shape, or I came into on shape, and started designing. And this is basically the tunnel piece that you've just seen me dig out. And after about 400 years of working it all out, this is kind of what I come up with. So I'll go through it a little bit. I've got an on off switch now integrated in. Obviously there with the hole is, and then the wires come through here. I've got rails, and the rails accept the base plate now for the ESCs. So I've got obviously print two of those, one either side, and they can slide wherever I want. This little part here is now where the four pack battery goes for the receiver, and then we come to the battery cover that then clips on, and the receiver goes in this space. The wires come through here, and it's big enough to accept a different receiver. And then cover it over with the front piece, so that's all looking kind of slick. And then the back cover, so the battery pack doesn't flop out the back there. Okay, so that's it from the back. We've got a couple of little groove outs here just for the little deals that screw the latches on. so they don't interfere with that. So there you go, guys. There it is, the tunnel piece. So let's carry on. Okay guys, so after all that messing about, it's all black so it's hard to see, but you know, these are my boxes for my capacitor banks. You saw those printing, and then I dug the hole out a little bit more for the cabling, and that basically then slips in there. Okay, nice and flush. We have a cover, I've got a cutout there, I've got a cutout here for the cables, I've got a re-solder. And that slips in there, okay, to cover up my capacitor banks. Cables come out, which then, you know, this is all clear for a battery, basically. It's the whole deal. And then we've got our tunnel, okay, switch is on. Wires are kind of in because they're all attached to the switch. And then this goes in. This is tricky one-handed, but we'll get there. Okay, that basically makes a lovely sound as we squeeze her in there, all right? But that fits in there beautifully, okay? That's one half of the tunnel. And then we come around the back here and we slip our back piece in. Boom. Okay, and that all links up. So now we've got our ESC here. Got my base plate on that we printed. Now, these lines up with the rails. That's in the rails now. And then that slips back in and under. All right, this cable will end up going to the, and end up getting put away nicely, cable management. So that's under there now, two of them, obviously, twin jets. So we've got them going on, and then we've got this deal. This, the four battery pack goes in there for the receiver, okay? And then this thing clips on, all right? Clips on lovely, it's not moving anywhere. And then we've got our front cover. So now receiver then will be in here, connected, obviously all the wires will run. And then our final, boom, nice positive click. Okay, it's not going anywhere. The ESCs, I'm gonna have to work out a way of just kind of, I think with the wires attached, they won't really move, but I'll just work out a way of, you know, sticking them where I want them, because they slip. That's the other cover, the other capacitor bank side, goes in that one there. Just putting that in for you. They're quite sort of snug. There we go. So that then slips in there. Capacitor bank in there. Wires coming out to the ESC, obviously. The cover goes on. All right. And they're tucked away. So everything's tucked away. And then we've got the jet drives. These were leaking slightly out of silicon. I've got loads of silicon all around. I'm going to change the pipe in. I'm going to have a double. The ESCs are going to get water separate to the motors, and it's all going to be shorter now. The phase wires are just, I've already shortened them actually a little bit too much, but that was for the other cabling I had. So now these are going to link to the motors, short, less buildup of resistance, etc., heat, and yeah, more cooling. So there you go, guys. That is the that is what I've been up to. Like I say, I'm going to try and get a bit more going on. I've got some appointments coming up for the hospital, but I'll be on it. You know, if you're in it, you're in it. If you subscribe, lovely, comment, like, and all that good stuff, and that keeps this channel, or it starts the channel, really going. So you know, if you can hit those buttons for me, guys, that'd be beautiful. There we go. Get in there. Clean this bottom section up. I'm gonna obviously get to making a battery one day. I'm gonna test this thing on the 8S setup that I had with the new jet drives and just see the difference heat wise and, you know, if I get a bit more power coming out of these things once they're the right size. Without these inserts, you can't really see, but the plastic inserts, the 58mm, I'll just make the drive nice and more efficient. So anyway, guys, if you like the video. And I'll see you on the next one, guys. Take care. Bye. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Slips off the fucking chair.